everyone, welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Ashim Datta and today we are going to discuss about characteristics of a diode and its order code is 36149. So in this video we are going to discuss about its working. Now let's see the components that are present on the kit. So this is the DC voltmeter. Here we will measure plate voltage. Then there is a switch which we will use to select the voltage range. Suppose we want to measure the voltage to 20 volt, then we have to keep the switch position at 20 volt. And if we want to measure the voltage above 20 volt, then we have to keep the switch position at 1000 volt so that we can measure the voltage up to 1000 volt. Then this is the DC current meter. Here we will measure plate current, and here also the switch is present so that we can select the range. Suppose we want to measure the current up to 20 milliampere, then we have to keep the switch position at 20 milliampere like this. And if we want to measure the current above 20 milliampere, then we have to keep the switch position at 200 milliampere so that we can measure the current up to 200 milliampere. Then this is the AC volt, and we can select the AC volt range. Suppose we want 2 volt, then we have to keep the port position at 2 volt. And if we want to keep it at 3 volt, we have to keep the port position at 3 volt. And if we want to keep it at 4 volt, we have to change the port position at 4 volt like this. Then this is the EZ80 valve, and these are its connecting points. Then this is the variable supply port. So by using this port, we can vary the voltage from 0 to 300 volt like this, and this is the fuse of 100 milliampere. So that's all the components of this kit. Now let's perform the experiment on the kit. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the positive terminal of DC voltmeter to the positive terminal of DC current meter. Then we will connect the negative terminal of DC voltmeter to the third terminal of EZ80. Then we will connect the negative terminal of DC current meter to the seventh terminal of EZ80. Then we will connect the positive terminal of DC current meter to the positive port of variable supply. Then we will connect the third port with the negative of variable supply. Then we will connect the AC volt port to the fourth port of the EZ80 and this port of AC volt to the fifth port of EZ80, and we have to keep the DC voltmeter switch at 1000 volt and the DC current meter switch at 200 milliampere. So that is how the connection is done. So after the connection is done, now we will switch on the kit, and we have to keep the variable supply voltage at zero position. We can see the variable supply voltage at this plate voltage or DC voltmeter, and we have to keep in mind that the EZ80 current limit is 90 milliampere as mentioned in the manual, but for safety we will not exceed the EZ80 current limit above 80 milliampere. And you can see the current that is flowing through the EZ80 will be shown on the DC current meter, that is the plate current. So now the first reading we will take it at 2 volt. So we will keep the AC volt at 2 volt, and now we will vary the variable supply. So by using this port we will vary the variable supply. So here we will keep increasing the voltage, and you can see the change in voltage at this DC voltmeter or plate voltage. This EZ80 filaments need 2 to 5 minutes for heating, so before starting the experiment we have to wait for 2 to 5 minutes so that EZ80 valve get heats and it is ready to operate. So after 3-4 minutes wait, you can see that the value of DC current meter changes when we increase the variable supply voltage. So now if I increase the variable supply voltage, we can see the changes in the DC current meter. So here you can see that when I keep the variable supply voltage at 151 volt, 0.1 milliampere current is showing on the plate current. And when we increase this variable supply voltage, so here you can see that when we increase the variable supply voltage, the variable supply voltage ranges from 0 to 300 volt, so we can vary the voltage. So now I am keeping the variable supply voltage at 200 volt, so we can see that the plate current is 0.4 milliampere and when we increase it to 300, so here you can see that the variable supply voltage or the plate voltage is 300 volt and the plate current is 0.4 milliampere. So this is the reading which we get at 2 volt. So now we will change the AC volt to 3 volt. So firstly we will zero the variable supply voltage. So by rotating this variable supply port in anti-clockwise direction, we can see that the DC voltmeter gets zero, and now we will change the AC volt to 3 volt by using this variable port. Now we will again do the same procedure, we will increase the variable supply voltage and we can see the changes in the current on the plate current. So here you can see that when I keep the variable supply voltage or the plate voltage at 200 volt, we can see that the plate current is 0.1.4 milliampere. Then if we increase the plate voltage to 250 volt, so we can see that the plate current reading is 2.2 milliampere. And if we increase the voltage to 300 volt, so here you can see that the plate current is increasing. So here you can see that it is approx 5 milliampere. Now we will perform the experiment at 4 volt. So for that we have to keep the variable supply at 0 volt. And now we will keep the AC volt at 4 volt by using this port. Now we will vary the voltage, but at 4 volt we have to do this experiment slowly, because at 4 volt the current increases rapidly and it can harm our EZ80. So for the safety of EZ80, we have to do the experiment at 4 volt very carefully. So now we will increase the variable supply very slowly. So here you can see that as I have increased the variable supply voltage to 30 volt, you can see the plate current changes and it is at approx 8 milliampere. So at a minute change in the plate voltage, the plate current increases rapidly. So we should not exceed the plate current above 80 milliampere. So we have to do the experiment at 4 volt very carefully. so that our kit or the EZ80 valve did not get any damage. So here you can see that when I keep the variable supply voltage at 100 volt, the plate current is approximately 12 milliampere. So that is how we can perform this experiment. So that's all the demonstration from my side. If you have any query related to this kit, you can contact at Tesca Global website. You can find the link in the description. For more information, go through the manual. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe to our channel.